The principle is to use India as a very large democracy that kind of anchors the region with the US on the other side of the Pacific, says Elizabeth Economy, a China expert with the Council on Foreign Relations. It's also hardly a substitute for Trump's nixing of TPP or the fact that, 1 year into his term, the diplomatic corps remains threadbare. Key allies Australia and South Korea don't have US ambassadors. Also worrying is Trump's transactional attitude. Nations fear that America first means they may be sold down the river whenever Trump sees a better deal. There isn't a sense of a larger vision or even a short-term plan of how the status quo is going to be defended in the face of China, says Professor Nick Bisley, an Asia expert at Australia's La Trobe University. The contrast couldn't be more striking between Xi Jinping, who has a very strategic view about where it's going and what it wants to achieve, he adds, noting that there's no doubt that Xi's ambition is for China to become the predominant power globally. On Friday, a senior Chinese finance official said that his government would ease foreign ownership obstacles in the finance and auto sectors and remove them in 3 to 5 years to assuage Trump. This is something Washington has been after for years, though the question is what quid pro quo Beijing has secured in return. Former U.S. Ambassador to China Max Baucus recently told CNN that Beijing may butter up Trump in order to secure a U.S. pledge not to interfere in Asian affairs. That would be a big problem, he said. The U.S. cannot fall for that. Hun Sen is China's wunderkind, writes Carlisle Thayer, professor emeritus at the Australian Defence Force Academy. As a result of Beijing's economic dominance and American withdrawal, adds Thayer, mainland Southeast Asia will be drawn more into China's orbit. We are not going to let the United States be taken advantage of anymore, he said. I am always going to put America first in the same way I expect all of you in this room to put your countries first.